Because you heard this before, and they didn't finish it the last time, and so you really don't have a lot of confidence that they're going to finish it this time.
Come on.
Some of you grew up in a neighborhood like mine where if you started a fight, you had to finish it. Don't push me because I'm close to the end. Trying not to lose my head. But when we arrive at the text, I got to hurry along.
Come on now.
Jesus has not arrived. Pastor Ellington on a $1 billion aircraft carrier.
That's right.
Lady Portia, he has not arrived on a multi-$1 billion jet airplane. Arrived here having been unjustly imprisoned, prosecuted, and sentenced. He arrives here after those that celebrated him on Sunday, Brother Cam, were the ones that said crucify him on Friday. Do I have anybody in here? I preached on prom Sunday, pastors, and I talked about temporary cheerleaders. And you need to understand, in life, you're going to have some temporary cheerleaders. Pastor J.I., you're going to have people that cheer you when you're up, but when you're down, they ain't nowhere to be found. But the last time I checked, a brother is born for adversity. What's this?
Yes, sir.
So, he's been beaten with a cat nine tails. He's had a crown of thorns on his head. And he's carried a very heavy cross.
Yes.
The cross that you and I cannot carry.
Come on, sir.
He's carried it anywhere from a quarter to almost a half a mile. And so now Jesus, after fighting the battle of his life, I think I'm ready to go home now, Bishop. After Jesus fighting the battle his life. Let me slow it down. I ain't gonna go there yet. After he's here fighting the battle of his life, not for weapons of mass destruction, but weapons of spiritual destruction.
Come on.
He found the weapons that we couldn't find.